birds all caged, the wild beasts all littered down, all the locks, chains, bars and bolts in good order? Is the little ease sufficiently uncomfortable? The racks, pincers and thumbscrews all ready for work? Ugh, you brute!
These allusions to my professional duties are in doubtful taste. I didn't become a head jailer because I like head jailing. I didn't become an assistant tormentor because I like assistant tormenting. You can't all be sorcerers, you know. But you brought that upon yourself.
Colonel Fairfax is not a sorcerer. He's a man of science and an alchemist.
Well, whatever he is, he won't be one for long. For he's to be beheaded today for dealings with the devil. His master nearly had him last night when the fire broke out in the Beacham Tower.
Oh, how I wish he had escaped in the confusion. But take care, there's still time for reply to his petition for mercy.
I'm content to chance that, for this evening at 7:30.
You're a cruel monster to speak so unfeelingly of the death of a young and handsome soldier.
Young and handsome? How do you know he's young and handsome?
Because I've seen him every day for weeks past, taking his exercise on the Beacham Tower.
Curse him!
Oh, there! I believe you're jealous of him now. Jealous of a man I've never spoken to. Jealous of a poor soul who's to die in an hour.
I am. I'm jealous of everybody and everything. I'm jealous of the very words I speak, for they reach your ears and I mustn't go near them.
How unjust you are! Jealous of the words you speak to me? Why, you know as well as I do that I don't even like them.
You used to like them.
I used to pretend I liked them. It was mere politeness to comparative strangers.
I don't believe you know what jealousy is. I don't believe you know how it eats into a man's heart and disorders his digestion and turns his interior into void.